Hey guys, this is Austin. It's been a while, but I am officially back with a brand new gaming PC build. Meet the Photon 4.0. The last year has been a really rough one for building a computer. Thanks to crypto mining, it has been incredibly difficult to get your hands on graphics cards, especially the ones that most people want to put in gaming builds. When you can find them, they're incredibly expensive, but more often than not, they're just going to be completely out of stock. Then, to make things even worse, other components have also been driven up in price. So high-end power supplies are really expensive right now, and memory is especially bad, with a lot of prices going for about double the price that they were last year. Put all of this together, and it has been really difficult to recommend any kind of new build. Well, at least until now. Thankfully, that changes today with the launch of AMD's new Ryzen processors with Vega graphics. Now no, this is not a sponsored video, however AMD did send out a little press kit including both Ryzen 3 as well as Ryzen 5. I mean, Ryzen 3 and Ryzen 5. The Ryzen 3 2200G is going to give you 4 Ryzen CPU cores that can clock up to 3.7 GHz, as well as 8 Vega GPU cores, very similar to the Ryzen mobile laptop that I recently reviewed. Now at only $100, this guy looks to be a pretty good performance bargain, especially considering that, with those kind of specs, some games are going to be playable even at 1080p. However, for this build, we're going to be going with the Ryzen 5 2400G. Now this adds hyper-threading to the quad-core processor, bringing the thread count up to 8, and you're also going to be getting a clock speed of nearly 4 GHz. Now almost more importantly for gaming, the Vega GPU cores have been bumped up from 8 to 11 on this guy. Now this does come with a heftier $170 price tag, which in context makes Ryzen 3 look like a pretty good deal. However, because this build we're going to go a little bit higher end, we decided to go with the Ryzen 5 2400G. For the rest of the build, we're using 16 GB of G-Skill FlareX DDR4 memory. Now at a super fast 3200 megahertz clock speed, this is specifically meant to work with Ryzen, and that extra power is going to be super helpful if you have a Ryzen APU. However, at a price on Amazon right now of over $260, this is probably not the best idea to pair with your $170 processor. Instead, I detuned this memory to run at 2666 megahertz to simulate running a much more reasonable $100 HyperX Fury X kit, which is going to have 8 gigs of RAM. I will say though that if you're looking to pick up a Ryzen with Vega chip, make sure that at the very least you get some reasonably fast dual channel memory. Those graphics definitely need some memory to be fed. Now at this point, it's hard not to notice our slightly unusual case pick. So this is the Thermaltake Core P1, and yeah, it's a little different than what we usually do here, especially for budget builds. With a solid piece of tempered glass up front, it looks really nice. Of course, it's not going to be the most practical system, with the entire sides being open. However, it does mean that you have a lot of different mounting options, including on this feet. You can even put this on a wall. Now, because we're using a Ryzen APU, there's actually plenty of space here because we're not installing the graphics card. However, if you do want to do that, there is an included riser cable where you can just drop it in. So for example, if you want to upgrade later down the road, you're set. For the motherboard, we're using the MSI B350 Pro AC. Now this actually isn't out yet, so I don't have the final price, but it is a pretty loaded little board. So in addition to full support for our Ryzen APU, including overclocking, you're also getting RGB, you have Intel Wi-Fi built in, and there's also a full-size DisplayPort, which means that, especially for a B350 board, you're getting a lot of features. Storage is being handled by a 500GB WD Blue SSD. Now I've used these in a few previous builds, and I like the price to reliability. However, one of the nice things about this guy is that it is available in an M.2 form factor, which especially for a clean build like this, means that we can actually stick it on the back of the motherboard to make the cabling even nicer. Even though power supply, as you guys will see, leaves a little bit to be desired. For that power supply, we're using a 500-watt EVGA bronze unit. Now there's nothing really wrong with it. I've used a lot of these in builds, they're gonna last a while, and they're fairly quiet. However, it's not a modular supply, which even though it is a little bit cheaper, means that your cabling is going to be a little bit challenged in this guy. Thankfully though, especially on the backside of this Thermaltake case, there's a fair bit of room to be able to run some stuff. So, maybe not the cleanest thing in the world, but it'll work. With a system like this, and especially if you're going with a Ryzen APU, a game that a lot of people are probably going to want to play is CSGO. Now here, with high settings at 1080p as I die, we're getting a pretty respectable 50 to 60 frames per second. One of the nice things is, because we are using a FreeSync high refresh rate monitor, if we do want to turn the graphics settings down to something like medium, we could in theory take advantage of that full 120Hz refresh rate. This is a bad idea, I'm gonna do this. Moving over to Rocket League, another game that I think a lot of people would play on a system like this, we're getting high quality settings at 1080p with a pretty solid frame rate of between 40 to 50. Just like CSGO, if you do like that higher frame rate over, oh, come on, get it, get it, get it, get it, get it. Yeah! But if you do want to get that higher frame rate, all you need to do is just crank the graphics settings down a little bit, and you can easily get well over 60 in pretty much all of these games.
Oh, that was not good.
It's funny, I've done a lot of videos on super budget systems lately. It's nice to see what Rocket League looks like when you actually crank the graphics up. I'm like on low all the time trying to get it to run on like $200 laptops. Moving on, we have Grand Theft Auto 5. Now here, running on normal settings at 1080p, we're between 40 to 50 frames per second. Not the smoothest thing in the world, but GTA 5, even for an older game, does run reasonably well. However, what I'm really curious about is how Ryzen, especially with those Vega GPU cores, are going to handle a more modern game. When it comes to Middle-earth Shadow of War, we're dealing with a much more demanding game. So here at 720p on medium settings, we're getting between 35 to 40 frames per second. It's totally playable, but when you get into those newer AAA titles, the graphics settings are definitely gonna have to come down. So, how does Ryzen with Vega stack up? For the most part, pretty well. You're getting a solid CPU along with decent graphics. Now, if you're only doing lighter titles, it's totally fine, but if you want to get into more hardcore gaming, at some point you probably do want to add a graphics card to this guy. With the Photon 4.0 itself, there is a lot of room for expansion. So you already have the really cool case, but there's lots of room in here to add that liquid cooling, to overclock your processor, add a graphics card, more drives. The sky's pretty much the limit. Considering where the PC market is today, I'm pretty happy with how the Photon 4.0 came out. It's a unique looking system that won't break the bank. So as always, links to check out all the parts you guys need to build this will be in the description. And something else you might want to check out is my 2018 gaming PC tutorial, where I show how to build everything here, although in a slightly different case. So feel free to go check that out over here, and I will catch you guys in the next one.